had children and a wife, had all the money he ever wanted, all the prestige, but he wasn't free. Lord Buddha wasn't free. So that's an example. He just said, no, I'm going to find the truth.
I love that story.
Yeah. It's a good one. Maybe y'all should look that up on the internet. It's all on the internet. Lots of versions of that.
It's a beautiful story, you know. Yeah. Yeah, maybe one day we'll do a video. I'll tell the story or something. We could tell the story.
We could. Like Lord Krishna, supposedly, according to the Bhagavad Gita, was sitting in a chariot with Arjuna and about to do battle. And then, like, the other guy, Arjuna, didn't want to do it after all. Didn't want to kill people.
Yeah.
And then, you know, and then Lord Krishna, supposedly, according to that, so that book stepped up and started giving them spiritual teachings, you know, before the battle, and stopped the battle to give them spiritual teachings, and that's where that came from.
Wow.
You know, like, you know, Arjuna thought that Krishna was his cousin, you know, and then it turned out he was a god, he was the infinite instead of doing, that's it, appearing as a person.
I never heard the story of Krishna, man. Like
that, you know. Maybe I need to get you a copy of the Gita. I will. Let me get that. Let me write that down.
If you can.
It's only a few dollars, $5 at Barnes & Noble.
Oh, man, I didn't try to do that.
That's a really interesting book. It's funny pronunciation, but it's if you want to look it up, it's spelled /horizontal/ You know, dad, it's the dash, not slash. That's what that is.
GITA. I might have that. You know what I mean?
You think you have it?
Yeah, I think I have that. I didn't even know I had it. I didn't know that was a Gita. You know?
See, I have a lot of books too. Where we get a lot of books and stuff, we get in this, it piles up, and sometimes one thing's in another. I see what you're talking about.
Yeah, the spelled like that, you know.
That's how it's spelled.
Yeah,
That's it.
I thought it was the Basha Ajavata.
Yeah.
Something like that, you know. Okay.
But
I might have a copy of the Gita, I didn't even know it.
But what I can recommend if you read about Lord Buddha and the pursuit, if you're reading about Lord Krishna and his teaching, or you're reading the Bible about Lord Christ and his teachings, or you're reading the Quran about Lord Muhammad and his teachings, you know, you have to do it in a way, and not every word is literal. You have to use your mind to tell you what's truth and what's been altered over the centuries by humans. You know, the truth will just fly out at you if you read it with that intuitive open mind.
When I used to read about the Buddha, I could smell flowers, you know, all the time, you know, in the air. I remember that. And I don't read about the Buddha as much anymore, you know. But I, you know, but there was a time.
No need to read about it. You can talk to him.
There was a time where I
talked to him.
You know, I could smell the flowers, you know, reading about the Buddha. That was a positive time in my life where I studied Buddhism very heavily. I would meditate for, you know, big long periods of time a day and stuff, and sit in front of the candle and meditate. You know, I just wanted to say that's a good way to be if you want to be, you know.
Lots of forms of meditation, but
yeah.
It's you have to find the path that will set you free. It might be none of the above. Nothing we said, because, you know, there's other paths, there's many others.
Yeah, I mean, it didn't stick, I guess.
It's none of the above for me. It's a little bit of some of those, but with my own thoughts and with some other books. That's how I got here. It started out like that. A lot of different ideas came to fruition and from different sources.
But definitely nothing wrong with Buddhism.
Nothing wrong at all. Because I remember we had a complaint, like somebody wrote upset. You know, we did their friend, I think it was a friend of this person, that person on that video on YouTube, you know what I'm talking about. We're not going to say the name now, but, you know, somebody was, like, saying, like, well, you know, my friend was a Christian, and he's not going to talk to Lord Buddha and this and that. But the thing is, Lord Buddha was coming through talking to the family, like, look, to heal over his murder, you're going to have to learn about letting go of all things. You know, he was coming through, he teaches, Lord Buddha teaches. And on the other side, there's no one religion or belief. It's many different things, and, you know, all leading to the same place. Yeah, I wanted to comment on that.
Yeah, I was real surprised about that.
I think that what I'm seeing, like, I was thinking about that this morning, is the guy is just upset inside. Like, the guy's own people have died, and the person who wrote that note on the comment on the video, he's had his own relatives die, and this person was murdered, and the guy just is taking out anger in the wrong place.
I think you're right, yeah.
You know.
Yeah, just say it. Well, yeah.
We didn't ask this person to come through. He wanted to come through. For a whole year, he was coming through, asking to come through.
The Buddha said he didn't need any protection, though. He didn't need for me to be upset about it, you know?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like that, you know? But I understand.
Yeah, there's nothing I'm not upset about. I mean, I wrote a response to it, but I was, like, explaining it in a nice way, friendly, just writing back to the guy. Yeah. Of course, he hasn't logged into YouTube to check his messages in a while. You can see the last login. Next time he logs in, he'll see.
All right.
It'll come in, so.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
The answer, that's who he answered. That was a question answered. You never know, but, you know, see, some people just are so rigid. I'm not trying to talk negative and make anyone feel bad. But if you're going to go on the spiritual path or you want to feel this stuff and learn, you have to open your mind first. You can't be rigid. Yeah. Rigidity, it'll just hold you prison, spiritual prison, or mental prison. You know? Mental rigidity, it just holds you there. You're in chains and shackles and handcuffs. Still.
I was feeling the vibe of it was like, you know, maybe like, I can't tell, man. You know what I mean?
It's just a soldier vibe, not any particular one. Yeah. It's just the idea of being a soldier and the what's behind it.
Yeah, I mean, he's got a little soldier outfit type thing on, but I don't see where he's from, you know.
I get the feeling that he represents more than one.
So,
you know, it represents an idea and a concept.
Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah, he's just a soldier at heart.
Soldier at heart. So that soldier is soldier.
Yeah.
Yeah, I could call it that.
He's just saluting through like this, you know.
Much appreciated.
Yeah. I just seen that, man. You know, I just wanted to say that.
We get this a lot, dude. It's random ones that just pop on through here and then pop out.
Yeah. My vibe just sucked right into him, and I was like, okay.
So, I didn't feel that one the same way he did. I didn't get sucked in, but I felt psychically what was going on with it.
Okay.
You know, like sometimes we would interpret things through different means. Let me check the time here. I think we're coming up on about 17 minutes. We got a couple minutes left in this video. But you can take a note about the idea of the next video. We're talking about spiritual freedom a lot this one, which is good. It's about freedom and freedom from false ideas, false beliefs, false truths, you know, false teachers. You have to see for yourself. You know, don't take every word we say, you know, and say what the Lord Buddha told people too. You know, for us, don't take what we say as gospel, put it to the test. For yourself. That's what Lord Buddha told people about his teachings.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. Lord Buddha said, you know, to his own son, you know, he can't teach him, you know, anything, you know, that, you know, he couldn't have taught himself, you know.
Yeah.
He can only lead him in a certain direction, you know, and he would still have to find it for himself.
That's right.
You know, it's a wise bit of time to lead them in a certain direction, you know.
It's just a waste that you do.
Exactly.
You can lead in a certain direction. It's not a waste. You can lead, but if forever trying to show somebody it never works. They have to see it for themselves.
Well, it's no use for a son to try to be the Buddha.
Oh, no.
Because he couldn't be the Buddha. You know, I think the Buddha was trying to say, you know, you can be, but, you know, I can't show you how to be like me, you know.
Yeah.
You know,
to learn on your own.
Yeah, like, you know, it's real... I guess you understand.
I do.
Yeah, you know.
I do.
This is a crazy concept, you know.
We're going to leave it here because we're about to run out of time in 20 minutes. We're about to start part 2.
All right, peace.
Peace.